Hey YouTube, Robbie coming to you guys here with a really cool deck profile that I've been working on for a while. I'll say now that most of the cards aren't here in my person yet, but it's only like a couple of extra copies of the cards that I'm missing, and there's just two cards that I don't have yet that I will just use my phone to show you guys what they are. But as you can see here on the title, this is a bug deck. From the newest set, Dawn of Majesty, the Beetrooper cards came out. And these cards are really, really, really cool, honestly. I'm a really big fan of them. I didn't think I would like bug cards really at all. I hated Insectors. But I just really put my brain to a lot of collective work, and I came up with this cool deck list so far. Honestly, there's some wiggle room here and there, and it's what I'm trying to do with the deck. A lot of other people could try other things, and I'm sure once the Insector spell comes out, if it's actually just insane, it might change the deck a whole lot. But for now, the Beetrooper card's got a couple of cards that are really cool, so we're into the deck. The first off is Scout Buggy. This guy is basically Tour Guide for an extra copy of himself, or Galaxy Worm, if you want to look at it that way. But he can also pull from the graveyard, so if you summon one, get another copy, do some stuff. Next turn, you can summon him, you get one back from the graveyard. So he's really cool. Big fan of this card, honestly. Then I only have one copy of this card from my box that I got at the sneak peek, but I'm definitely playing three copies of this card. So in total, there should be three. This card is basically Kagamucha Knight if you summon another insect monster. He's got a 2K butt, which is really nice. And then during your opponent's turn, or whenever your opponent activates a monster effect, you can tribute one insect monster and destroy the monster. So it's kind of got a pseudo ghost ogre effect while on the field. So you can tribute itself, blow up a whatever they have on the board, doesn't really matter. That's not crazy, honestly, but it's fine. But his Kagamucha effect is really nice because it chain blocks this from getting ashed. So he's a solid three of. Just an extender. It's just a really cool card. And then one of the Sting Lancer, I might cut this card honestly, but he's really good in the long term of things. I'm sure if you built this deck to go second, it would be way better for this card. But the way that I'm building the deck is just the combo going first. Quick effect, you can shuffle back an insect monster in your graveyard, or put on the bottom of the deck, I believe, and one monster in your opponent's graveyard on the bottom of the decks, then summon him, and then he can search for a Beetrooper spell or trap card, which right now there's only two. But that's kind of a cool thing to do overall. I really like him in general, but that just relies on your opponent having a hand trap and hand trapping you for his effect to go off. So we only have one copy of him for now. That is all for the Beetrooper monsters for the main deck. We only got these three in the set. So that kind of really had to push the limits on what other bug cards could we play. And I went through a lot of ideas, Giant Ballpark was not good enough in my opinion. There's too many disruption cards on that, and that's just, I felt like that wasn't going to be doing enough for the deck, honestly. I really spent a lot of time and researched into the digital bug cards. What we're gonna do is, these are the ones I'm playing. I'll go over them and everything from here on out. There's other ones that aren't being played as well, but we'll get into it. So the first one is Registrider. It's one of the newest ones from the set, or from Blazing Vortex, I believe. What he does is, he's also a Kagamucha Knight for insects, kind of like this guy. So he's really cool on that aspect, but he can be on any insect. And then when you do that, he can also make the other monster that you normal summoned a level 5 or a level 7 star monster along with himself. So that makes kind of some cool plays for the extra deck that we'll get into in a little bit. And then if this card is special summoned, you can change the battle position of one of your insect monsters, which really only matters for one of the other digital bugs. And then if you use him as exceed material for a light bug, it does another effect, but that's more than likely not going to come up. His is, it gains 1,000 attack and defense. All the digital bugs have that kind of effect, but again, those aren't gonna come up all that often. So yeah, that's that one. The next one is Centibit. This is the only digital bug besides this one that you can't manually switch to defense to do a thing. We are playing two copies of this. I only own the one. But when he says, when he has switched positions, tour guide for a level 3 insect monster from your deck. So so if you like hard draw him, you can just be like normal, special, make them both 7s, switch him to defense, and then he can trigger to get scout, which gets you another scout. So like, that's a lot of pressure off just two cards to do a lot of things. But again, this card only works when you have this card. So that's why I cut him down to 2. At first I read him and I thought he could just manually switch himself to do that effect, which would just be bonkers. But unfortunately, he does not have that ability on itself, like the rest of the other like normal digital bugs. And then his effect when he's attached to a light exceed, or an exceed monster that was using him, it can does piercing, or no, attacks all monsters once. So that also does not probably come up too often, but there should be 2 copies of him. And then the last 2 digital bugs, we play 1 copy of each, just because it's just kind of the not so great ones compared to these two. And there's like another 1 or 2 that just aren't that good at all. This one is Debris Dragon. You switch it to defense and get back another insect from the graveyard. So this one's really cool because you can do a lot of things with that. And just kind of like continue to do link climbing. Then he gives the monster Armades effect, so they can't use effects until the end of the damage step. And then Web Soldier. You switch him to defense and you can summon a level 3 from your hand in defense. So he's kind of the worst one that you only really want to do later combo if you have like another copy of a dude to summon just to like keep going. If you draw him off the injector. So he's kind of just there. And then his other effect is, the actually kind of crazy one is the, if you exceed summon with him going second, the monster gains the effect to turn all your opponent's monsters to defense and they have 0 defense. So that's kind of cool. That really won't matter in terms of actual Yu-Gi-Oh! But yeah. So that's the digital bug package. So far, I've been really liking them and it's kind of just really depends on the rest of your hand. But the card that I really want to talk about is the next one that goes with this card. That really like does a lot of cool stuff. I mean, this card also works really well with Centibit. So these two go with our next card, which is Transicadia. We're playing 3 copies of this card. Again, I only own the 1 copy right now. This card says if it's special summoned, you get a molt token. Okay, something that, you know, we don't have here in the TCG, obviously. Darn for making tokens that don't exist. But while you control the token, you can't special summon from the extra deck except insects, and you can only use that effect once per turn. So he's what summons this from the deck and then gets you an extra token. But if you normal summon this card and then summon this card and make him a level 5, you can make Zulkin because this is a tuner. So I thought that was kind of cool, and we'll get into the extra deck in a little bit. You will see that I am playing Zulkin Crystal Wing just because of that, like, interaction. What's also really cool about this card is none of its effects are once per turn whatsoever. So if you open like 2 copies of this card, you can just go ham jam, thank you ma'am. Which was really just crazy about like the digital bug cards. All right, the last couple of monsters, the last 2 like weird insects before we get into like the idea of my deck more or less is, I'm playing 2 Battle Wasp monsters. These are just extenders for the deck that aren't really that good, but like you need more insect extenders for the deck for the sake of just extending. This being level 3 doesn't really matter, You can special summon him, but when you do, you can't special summon for the rest of the turn except insect monsters from the extra deck. So that cuts off making like access code talker or the Zulkin play unless you do this like way last. And then this one says you can special summon it and then deal 200 to your opponent for each copy of itself on the field. You're just gonna play the one copy. So having that like minor burn damage is super cute. But you know, I just wanted some more insects to kind of like get into link climbing. Next is another card that I ordered that I will be showing off on my phone. This is Scary Moth. So this is basically Winda, but in insect form. So there's a really fun way that you summon this card from your deck, and it's a brick to draw. If you draw it, you're trying to get it to the graveyard and then recycling it back to the deck as quickly as possible. Other than that, it's just the brickiest card in the deck, but we're trying to set up summoning this card on our opponent's turn, and I'll show you how we do that soon. Next is our only hand trap besides Imperm is Ash. So I'll just get into the Imperm now. These are our, you know, six hand traps. These just cover a lot, and this being able to be set for Zulkin is just kind of nice. So yeah, that is all for that. Next is spells and the remaining trap, and then we'll get into the extra deck. All right, there should be three copies of this card. They're on the way in the mail. Cocoon of Ultra Evolution. So what you do is you tribute an insect monster from either side of the field with an equipped card, and if you do, special summon an insect from your deck, and then you can, ignoring its summoning conditions, but that doesn't matter for our deck, and then during your main phase, if this card's in your graveyard, you can banish it and return an insect to the in your deck and then draw a card. So that effect doesn't come up often enough, but we are playing three copies of this card because we want to see it for the sheer fact that we really want to Scary Moth our opponent. And I'll show you how we equip the card when it comes to the extra deck. So we have three copies of that card. That card is kind of getting a little pricey. There's only two printings for the TCG and then the one for Speed Duel, but we can't play with that, so irrelevant. But yeah. Next is the Beetrooper field spell. I have two copies of it and one terraforming. I have thought about three copies of it and one or no terraforming, but I'd rather have the ability to side deck other cards with terraforming in the future if I do build a side deck with this deck. Yeah, so what this card does is if while you have it on the field, you can target an insect, a Beetrooper, sorry, a Beetrooper in your graveyard, special summon it, it can't attack, and then you lose life points equal to the original attack. So it's basically an extender on a field spell card, which is really cool. And then if an insect monster you control is destroyed by battle or card effect, so super cool for future, you know, maybe playing it with insectors with this card, you get a token, you can only use that effect once per, or each effect once per turn. So kind of a cool card, honestly. Next we have three Pot of Prosperity. The extra deck is a little free in here to the point where we can play this card for three almost all the time. And we just wanted consistency to really get into our combo pieces, either being this card, normal summon this card, or this card. We really just want to see the cards that we play three copies of each. And this is the best way to do it in this deck, honestly, is just trying to up your consistency as high as possible. The deck is a solid 40 cards, so yeah. Next, we have Called by the Grave. We really just want to try to resolve our cards. Not a whole lot stops this deck. If you can get the chain blocking with the way that you have a lot of the insects going, but you still just need Called by just in case. And then we have Monster of Orn, just as an extender. I couldn't really think of anything else to put in this like 40th slot besides Upstart. So I thought Monster of Orn would just be a little better because you can do a little more. And then lastly, we have three Beetrooper Fly and Sting. This is the counter trap that's really cool. So what it does is when your opponent activates a monster effect, while you control a Beetrooper monster, doesn't have to be the big guy, it could be anybody, you can negate and destroy that monster. And then during your end phase, if you control a insect with 3,000 or more attack, which there's only really one that has it in this deck, that's in the extra deck, you can banish an insect and set this card. So I thought about trying some cool cards with like Foolish Bearer of Goods, where you send this card, and then end phase, you just have instant access to it. But I just didn't find any other synergy too hardcore, except maybe for the sheer fact that you could Foolish Bearer of Goods this as well and have it be an extender. Not sure yet. That is a cool prospect that I could think about trying the deck next. But until then, this is just kind of what I've been toying around with for now. If I cut the Zulkin idea maybe a little bit, then I'll try that next, but I don't know. So yeah, that is our deck. It is 40 cards main. Next, I'm going to get into the extra deck. I'm going to start with the Link monsters, and normally I go oldest to newest, with Links being last. But since this is a brand new archetype, I really thought I'd get into the Beetrooper cards first. We're playing two copies of Armor Horn. This is a Link 2 that just takes two insect monsters. So really, you can make this off of just, you know, the token with Transacadia and this, if you special summon it, or just, you know, the way the deck plays is you're gonna get a lot of insect monsters and swarm the field. Haha, see what I did there? So what this card does is you can not special summon except insects, and then when you make this card, you can extra normal summon an insect for the turn. So pretty good, considering we have a fair number of those insect monsters that we wanted for extension. Like I said, like this, if you do this in the later play where you're making cards go off, it's fine. If you can make this some way and then you're going to do this play afterwards, or you can just normal summon this guy again and then get his effect off, or, you know, the Debris Dragon one, if you draw it, you can just normal summon and then Debris Dragon guy back another bug. So a lot of really good choices for that extra normal summon just to continue Link climbing, because you really are trying to push to making, you know, this card as much as you can. So, and then his other effect is you can banish three other insect monsters from your graveyard while he's in the graveyard, and then special summon him, but he gets banished when he leaves the field. So again, that helps Link climbing a fair amount just to try to make this card a lot quicker. So really it's just kind of nice. And then the extra copy is there for Pot just in case as well. Normally I banish one copy of him and something else, just to get Pot to go off, but having the extra copy in the extra deck is nice. Next is the other Beetrooper. We have Giant Beetrooper Invincible Atlas. We play two copies of this card. I don't have two copies yet because I only got one at the sneak peek. But what this card is while his attack is 3,000 or less, your opponent can't target or destroy him with card effects. You can't summon except insect monsters with him, and then you can tribute one insect monster and activate one of the two effects that he has. You can special summon a Beetrooper from your deck, so he can summon this guy, which gets the counter trap, which is pretty nice, or you can summon this guy, get another Link play going off turn two after your first turn of setup, or just other stuff like that. You can only use one of his effects per... Oh, and then the other effect is he gains 2,000 attack until the end of the turn. So that'll shut off his first effect of not being destroyed, but he does do a lot of damage if he's 5k for, you know, a big bug. So, yeah, we play two copies of this card. Normally I banish one off Prosperity as well, but it's just... It's kind of what, like, you're trying to end on, like, the towers kind of monster. Next is two copies of Insector Pico Falania. I like this card a lot. So far in testing, you can make both of these in one turn. The only thing that's kind of weird about when you do that is, like, the first one, you don't use its Link Summon effect to attach a guy. You use its first effect to put three back, draw a card. Then you make another copy of this, and then you use that first effect again after you've drawn that extra card. Because sometimes when you're, like, you know, dropping your hand on the table of all your insects, your hand kind of gets depleted kind of quickly. So her effect to discard sometimes just isn't always available, and you have to target another insect on the field, not her. So, like, you're gonna try to wait until you can link climb a little further before you use that effect. If you like don't have the hand to extend to make two, then you banish one off prosperity as well. So it's just, it's good to have both, but yeah. And then our next one is Seraphim Papillion. This card gains attack for each counter on it, and it gains counters for each different insect with different names that made it. So that's pretty cool. And then a quick effect, you can remove a counter and special summon a level 4 or lower insect from your graveyard in defense. So again, this just lets you be able to continue extending, which, I mean, this card lets you keep doing that as well, because this is normal or special, or this is only normal summon. But it doesn't negate the effect of the monster summoned. So if you summon this guy back, kill's effect will trigger and switch a guy to defense to get it off. So this just helps you link climb into your big Beetrooper. So there's the bug link monsters. Next is part of the other extra deck, and so we have the Zulkin package, just these two, in case you can get off that crazy play without the restriction of being stuck under bugs. So I might cut this if I cut the Transicadias play, but this just seemed really cool for the deck at the time being, just because it's something different. Our other like link monsters are Access Code and Unicorn, just in case, like if you're not stuck under link or the insect restriction, you make these and you can just kill your opponent. Yeah, especially with Seraphim being able to make this guy so easily, being three, it's just super nice. And then we have four Exceed monsters. We have two digital bugs, so we have one of this card. This card takes two or more level three light insects, so you can only really make it with the digital bugs. You can't really make it with the other cards. But during either player's turn, you can detach the two materials from him, target a monster your opponent controls, and change its battle position. And if you do, you negate its effect. So really, that's like not the craziest thing ever, but when it destroys a card, you can equip it as material to him as well afterwards. So he's not the crazy, crazy one, but it's just an option to make into with the digital bugs. Afterwards, you can make Downard on top of this and Zeus, but you can also make Zeus on top of the other card that I don't have, which is the digital bug Rhinos Bus. So what he does is, if he attacks a defense position monster, does piercing, and then during either player's turn, you can detach a material, destroy the face-up monster your opponent controls with the highest defense. And if they have a lot of monsters tied with the highest defense, it destroys all of them. So you can make him off of this and any other guy that he makes a 7. Only digital bug, though. So any other like two digital bugs makes that. So that's some sort of form of interaction on your opponent's turn that's just not like negate the effects of anything with the counter trap or scary mothing your opponent to Winda. So I'll say the weakness that I can say this deck has is it doesn't have a whole lot of spell and trap protection like against it, and you have to draw like the absolute right hand, which is hard when it comes to deck building and hard to come like playing second. This deck probably just does nothing, more or less. But I thought I would really just try my hardest to build a deck out of the new Beetrooper cards and really push an idea out there that was just way different. So I hope you guys give this a thumbs up and really like this video. I know it's a little bit of a longer video, but I thought I would go into the idea of the deck a little further than a lot of my other deck profiles, because this is a lot of brand new cards and a lot of cards that just aren't played in the meta, like the digital bugs or whatever. So, yeah. I'll catch you guys later. All right, peace, YouTube.